Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Barbell Medicine YouTube channel. I'm Dr. Jordan Feigenbaum. Today, we're going to talk about why everyone is wrong when they say that protein is going to hurt your kidneys. Thanks again for joining us. You know, one of the most common things that I hear when people talk about dietary protein is that, oh, I heard that it can hurt your kidney or it can hurt your liver. And so I figured let's take a 2-minute Tuesday and talk about how protein affects the kidney. So let's get 2 minutes on the clock and let's go. So where a lot of this comes from is data sets on people with pre-existing kidney disease. So there's the modification of diet on renal disease study, MDRD, or the Nurses' Health study, where they show that people who eat a very low protein diet who already have kidney disease tend to have a slower progression of decline to kidney disease. So there's 5 stages of kidney disease, and it's based on something called your glomerular filtration rate, which we use a series of lab tests to determine. So effectively, if you had labs suggesting that your glomerular filtration rate, the glomerulus being a part of the kidney, is worsening, we'd say, oh no, kidney's in bad shape. Why is it in bad shape? Most common causes, you know, diabetes, hypertension, also, you know, race, family history, gender, you know, stuff like that, all contribute to kidney disease. But in any event, the real question is, does dietary protein intake in an otherwise healthy individual or a person who does not have pre-existing kidney disease, does that do anything? So we've actually had many studies that look at this. You know, there are a lot of trials on higher protein diets for obese folks and see how they do with weight loss. And they've looked at their kidney function throughout the course of those studies with no changes. That would be an indication that dietary protein causes a worsening or some sort of kidney failure or sort of kidney disease onset. That doesn't seem to occur. We've actually looked at this in bodybuilders and what are called other athletes in the study. So these people were eating up to 2.8 grams per kilo per day. So this is over 1 gram per pound body weight, for instance. And their kidney function was no different. Didn't appear to have any deleterious activity. So the kidney function was effectively normal as measured in the labs. And so I'll link a bunch of these papers below and you can kind of read up on the history and basically all the data that we have on this stuff that I feel like is relevant. Probably one of the most succinct sort of summaries and recommendation sets that we have out there is from the JISSN, or the Journal of the International Society of Sports Nutrition. Here's what they say, and I'll read this as a quote and link the study, the position paper where this comes from. So vast research supports the contention that individuals engaged in regular exercise training require more dietary protein than a sedentary individual. Protein intakes of 1.4 to 2 grams per kilo per day for physically active individuals is not only safe, but may improve the training adaptations to exercise training. When part of a balanced, nutrient-dense diet, protein intakes at this level are not detrimental to kidney function or bone metabolism in healthy, active persons. And this has been shown in study after study after study. Effectively, the take-home is if you don't have pre-existing kidney disease, eating a higher dietary protein intake is not associated with a worsening of kidney function out of nowhere. There was this thought that when you eat dietary protein, the blood flow to the kidney and its filtration rate increase, and this is true. This happens when you eat at all, and certainly with dietary protein. Effectively, this is an adaptive response to eating. Okay, so when you're fasting, the blood flow to the kidney goes down, the glomerular filtration rate, or how hard the kidney's working, goes down. The problem is that the media and other places where people get information from use the word strain or stress the kidneys, but this is completely inaccurate for people who have, you know, good or normal kidney function to begin with. So I think it's something that we should stay away from saying, and certainly if somebody's telling you that, oh, you'll stress your kidney and you don't have kidney disease or you don't have diabetes, something that can, that basically causes kidney disease over time, something like that, then the protein intake really doesn't have any effect on you developing kidney disease. Another interesting thing is, as we age, our kidney function tends to decline, just a normal part of aging. But the most interesting thing is, when you look at the data on protein intake in older adults, it's actually more important for them to have a higher dietary intake of protein, mainly because they're less sensitive to dietary protein, so they're anabolic resistant. Now, this is due to many factors, but the point is, there's actually a study called the ProtAge study, which I'll also link below. It actually suggests that increased dietary protein intake improves the retention of muscle mass and the functional status of older adults. So we have evidence and recommendations and data sets that suggest that not only is dietary protein intake not harmful to those with normal functioning kidneys, but those who are older populations or those with chronic diseases that don't affect the kidney, that those folks would do just fine and may even benefit certainly from an elevated protein intake. So if you're training hard and you're worried about your kidneys or worried about your liver due to protein, that's completely not evidence-based. And now you know, because you just listened to the 2-Minute Tuesday. So, hey guys, I'm gonna be traveling to Australia. So I'll be out of pocket for like 12, 14 hours or something while I'm on this plane. So I won't be responding to comments, but as soon as I touch down, we'll see you guys there. And thanks as always for tuning in. If you like the video, hit like, subscribe, share with your friends, and we'll catch you next time.